in almost every tape that has been, I did a message called Woman Thou Art Loose.
Wait a minute, Jakes. You was just talking about your tapes and then you just jumped to Woman Thou Art Loose? You was just talking about all your tapes. Let's continue talking about the tapes. See, ladies and gentlemen, he was about to talk about his tapes and he jumped from that to Woman Thou Art Loose to give some more promotion to get you emotional people to start siding with him. You understand? He have a lot of tape series and books that deal with prosperity, but he jumped off that subject real quick because he know people gonna go out there, they gonna do their research, and they gonna find out that the majority of his tape library, videos, books, all major around financial prosperity with blessings and all of this materialism. He know that. So he want to jump now to the Woman Thou Art Loose thing to get the emotions going, to make the sensitive people begin to say, yeah, he do care about us, for real. No, he care about money. He's a businessman. That is his major. You have to understand that.
I did a message called Woman Thou Art Loose, which really exploded around the nation, and it dealt with women who had been abused and been assaulted, had been through domestic violence, and to say that there was a way out. And my ministry actually exploded. Sometimes when people learn who you are by reading an article or hearing an interview, and that's what they know of you, you can be put in a box that really doesn't fit you.
Maybe you have an image that's unfair.
Well, just in that one aspect, I'm not crying about it. I mean, people...
Because here's another question, Twitter. I do not have luxury possessions such as nice cars or homes. Am I not good enough? Does God favor you more than me?
Absolutely not.
These preachers are jokes, man. They totally boast all the time about how blessed they are and how if you're not prospering, something's wrong with you. Or if you don't have the nice house or the nice car, it's because you're not living right or you don't have enough faith. Or you're not giving enough, or, well, that's how they are, man. This man is full of crap, man. He know good and well that he believe God favors him more than other people who are less fortunate. That's the way it is. Even Creflo is the same way. They constantly boast about their materials. They constantly look down on people who don't have nothing as they're just poor or they don't have enough faith. And it's really wrong to base how a person is off of the materials they have. In other words, if you don't have a nice car or if you don't live in a nice house, then something is wrong with you. You just don't have enough faith or you're not living holy. The entire message behind the prosperity gospel is demonic. It's sick. And it makes people feel like the Most High is not with them unless they have materials like superstar preachers do. And constantly, when these preachers preach, they always push the fact that, you know, if you want to be blessed, you have to first of all sow a seed, because after all, the preacher has to prosper first and then you'll come up. In other words, if your preacher ain't rich and prospering, you can't prosper. So that's the message today, and that's what they're pushing. But now that the recession is on, they're feeling the pinch, the money ain't coming in, and the buckets are halfway full. So you know what's coming next. A lot of these churches are going to start closing down.
And see, I'm not on the side they think they are. The question is a great question, but they're sending it to the wrong guy.
Wrong guy? So who should they be sending it to, Mr. Jakes? Who should they be sending the question to? Creflo? How about Benny Hinn? Who? See, he's trying to distance himself, ladies and gentlemen, from the prosperity gospel. He wants the world to see him as a minister who is not a part of those crooked preachers who are all about name it and claim it and, you know, sow a seed and believe God and this is the year of the overflow and God has the miracle waiting for you. No, he don't want to be a part of that now because he know the questions are going to start coming in. People are going to start demanding answers. They're going to want to know why, Mr. Jakes, I've been sowing, I've been giving all my money to your church, but my family is struggling. I'm losing my job. job. My mortgage is over the top. My car was just repossessed. What is happening, Jakes? I've been tithing my tithe and the devourer has been devouring everything in my home. Why isn't this thing working, Mr. Jakes? He don't want no one to come to him with those questions. So what he have to do now? He have to begin to distance himself from other preachers by making himself look like he's the innocent one. And he's not. He's guilty. Blood is on his hand. The blood of all you people who've been giving your money to Jakes and ministers like him, the blood is on their hands. The reason why the majority of you are struggling is because you've been following these pulpit pimps, these wolves in sheep's clothing, these satanic preachers from hell, these New World Order preachers. You've been following them, and now that the recession is on, they're turning their backs from you. And sooner or later, they're going to pack up their bag and they're going to move to another country, another nation, and they're going to start pimping them over there too.
I work over in third world countries where there's great faith, and some of those people are hungry and starving. I don't define faith by materialism. I absolutely do not.
What keeps them going? What keeps you going when times are terrible, that belief remains?
I know what kept me going. I knew that God had not forgotten me. I knew that he was there with me. I did not define my relationship with God as Santa Claus just to give me what I needed. I do believe that God blesses his people. I certainly do. But all of those blessings are not always material all the time. Bless me with healthy children. Bless me with a loving wife. Bless me with health and strength. There's a lot of ways to be blessed.
If you really believe that God blesses his people, then why are contributions low, Mr. Jakes? Why are people struggling? Why are people who've been tithing forever are struggling and can't pay their bills? Why are so many Christians on the welfare line collecting stamps and public assistance? Why are people on the unemployment line, on the soup line, and trying to get a handout? Why, Mr. Jakes? Why isn't the prosperity gospel working now? Why is it that when hard times are hitting everybody, the sow a seed nonsense ain't in your tongue? How come you're not telling people to sow a seed, Mr. Jakes? How come? Because you know that you've been pimping people all these years, and now that the hard times are here, the curtain, the mask is coming off the prosperity gospel, and people are now seeing it for what it really is. It's a con game. It don't work. If God is really blessing his people, then the people should be blessed whether times are hard, whether times are good. It doesn't matter. We should see the church prospering all the time. All of this nonsense prosperity crap that been taught throughout this church is just a joke, man. Because now that you see the times are rough, people are beginning to wake up. They're beginning to look around them and say, wait a minute, what is going on? I've been giving and giving and giving, and I haven't been reaping no harvest. I thought the preacher man said that, you know, it doesn't matter if there's a recession, that God is going to still take care of me. Why am I losing my house, Mr. Jakes? You see, people, this man is now running for cover. And just like he's running, you're going to soon see videos with Creflo. You're going to see videos with all these preachers. They're going to start popping up all over YouTube and all over the news, where they're going to try to distance themselves from the prosperity thing as if though they were never a part of it.